Okay, this is me again, and I just fixed my problem with my Canon 70D camera. I just figured out what was wrong, and I'll show you what I did. And I did an unnecessary step, but it's not really a big deal. Okay, so I had some options. My option was either send it to Canon, and they're going to charge me an arm and a leg to fix it. That was one option. The other option is obviously buy another camera. The other option that I had was to take the camera apart and look for this loose screw that could be loose on the main board or the PC board or the motherboard or whatever you want to call it board. In other videos, people had the exact same problem and was able to fix it. So I had to purchase a kit with a screwdriver that was small enough. So this was small enough in order to fit into the screw head, you know. So I wasn't going to be able to do this without making a $6 purchase. So that kit, let's just call it $7. So this tool kit cost $7, and that's how I fixed my camera. So I took all the screws loose unnecessarily. Okay, so it was a few here, and it was a few here on the face. But I never took the camera apart. I never needed to. I already looked at the camera very closely before I started to repair it, and before I even had a problem, I looked at it very closely and I didn't see how it was going to come apart like the other cameras. I still don't know how to take it apart, but I don't need to know, because the problem was where some of the people who had experience, they actually knew what the problem was, and they were correct. Okay, so I've put the battery back in there because it's working, but I'm going to show you something that's overlooked, something that's very delicate, and they need to work on this. I saw this earlier, but didn't pay it no mind because I didn't know what it was. But inside here, inside this square, was the answer. It's obviously either some type of button or sensor. There's no way that you're going to be able to see clearly inside that hole. But inside this square, there is a like a little latch, or I don't know what the mechanism is. All I know is I took my pen and I aligned it. So it was off to the right or off to the left, and now it's in the center. So something told me maybe that's the issue. And that's when you close this. You know, this happens, you know, your car doors and everything that has like some type of a button or switch does this, you know, in your car door on your car. And I figured this edge needed to go inside of there and would do something either electronically or something mechanical wise. And I was correct. So a few seconds ago, when I played with that little whatever you want to call it, because I don't have a name for it, I was able to put it to the center. I immediately put in my battery just to see what was going to happen. And instantly, the camera came on. And it's telling me that the card is not in, but you see the dial is on, so the camera's actually working. So let me put the memory card back in there. This is a problem that you would probably even have with an older car. It's just a sensor issue. It's either a latch, which is mechanical, or it's a sensor, which is electronic. I'm not sure which one it is. I don't really care. I just know that I got it to work. And $7 versus $200 or versus $300 or the amount that it would take me to ship it. So I was able to get it to work. So you see, I have my power back on. So the lens is on there, but it's working. So $7 got my camera fixed. So now I'm going to post this video with what I posted earlier with the problem, with the solution, because someone else may have the exact same problem and they can save themselves a lot of money. Hope this helps someone. All right.